This is transmission line trainer. Order code of this trainer is 40510. On the panel, you can see terminals for the connection of different page codes are provided. A sine wave generator and square wave generator is available on the panel. And for this wave generator, this is the frequency adjustment for the output waveform, and this is the amplitude adjustment of the sine waveform and square waveform. You can select the output with the help of this toggle switch. When you put this switch in sine position, a sine wave is available between these two terminals. These are output terminals. And when you put this switch to square position, you can get the square wave from these terminals. This is the frequency selection. When you put this low position, you have selected low frequency range, and this is the high frequency range. So you can select the frequency range with the help of this switch. This is the potentiometer, and terminal of this potentiometer available on the panel. Between these two terminals, you can adjust the resistance with the help of this knob, and between these two terminals you can adjust the resistance with the help of this knob. Both potentiometer are 100 ohm value. So this is your transmission line trainer. The basic property of the coaxial cable which is used in this trainer, given in our manual, these are the basic properties of the coaxial cable which we have used in this trainer. Cable type is RG174 type. Length of this cable is 100 meters. Series inductance of this cable 33.9 microhenry at the frequency of 1 kilohertz. Parallel capacitance of this cable is 9.722 nF, frequency 1 kilohertz. Conductance of this cable is 0.4 microamp. Impedance of this cable is 50 ohm. This is the block for 25 meter cable. We have used the cable in coiled form in this trainer. So 25 meter cable is in coiled form. Another coil of 25 meter cable, this is second block, and third block is another 25 meter cable coil. Fourth block is last 25 meter cable coil. So these are the four group of 25 meter coil form cable. So total length of cable is 100 meter. This is input socket. This terminal is connected to center point of this socket, and this terminal is connected to outer of this socket. Between these terminal, 1 ohm resistance is provided, which is used in a experiment. So we are going to do different experiments on this trainer. First experiment is measuring the characteristic of a sealed line. So we are going to measure इंडक्टेंस, कैपेसिटेंस एंड ओमिक रेजिस्टेंस विद द हेल्प ऑफ एलसीआर मीटर. दिस इज आवर एलसीआर मीटर. वी आर गोइंग टू यूज दिस एलसीआर मीटर टू मेजर द इंडक्टेंस ऑफ लाइन, कैपेसिटेंस ऑफ ट्रांसमिशन लाइन एंड ओमिक रेजिस्टेंस. यू कैन मेजर द ओमिक रेजिस्टेंस विद द हेल्प ऑफ ओममीटर और डीएमएम. फॉर द मेजरमेंट ऑफ कंडक्टेंस एंड ओममीटर इज रिक्वायर्ड विच इज एबल टू परफॉर्म रेजिस्टेंस मेजरमेंट विद ए रेंज ग्रेटर देन 100 मेगा ओम. सो विद द हेल्प ऑफ 100 मेगा ओम रेंज मीटर यू कैन मेजर द कंडक्टेंस ऑफ लाइन. नाउ वी आर गोइंग टू मेजर ओमिक रेजिस्टेंस ऑफ द लाइन. सो जस्ट कनेक्ट द TP1, दिस इज TP1 टू सेकेंड पॉइंट TP3 connected to third block input and TP5 is connected to fourth block input. TP2 second input of second block. TP4 second input of third block. And TP6 second input of fourth block. So now your transmission line is connected. This is now 100 meter length. For the measurement of resistance, ohmic resistance of the line, we have to connect a LCR meter to the input of line. This is first terminal of first block. This is second terminal of first block. Last end of 100 meter line, TP7 and TP8. For the measurement of ohmic resistance, we have to sort TP7 and TP8 and just select the LCR setting to R and frequency to 1 kHz. And this is the value of ohmic resistance of the 100 meter length line. This is 18 ohm. You can measure this ohmic resistance with the help of DMM. And now we are going to measure inductance of the line. Just without any change in connection, just set the LCR to L. This is 31 micro Henry. This is the value of inductance of 100 meter long line. For the measurement of capacitance of the line, just disconnect the TP7 and TP8. This is open end line. Another end of this line is now open. TP7 and TP8 not connected. And just set the LCR meter to C. And this is the value of capacitance of 100 meter line. This is 9.97 nF, nanofarad. All these measurement we have done on 1 kilohertz frequency and compare the readings obtained by you with those specified which is in our manual. So according to the properties of this cable is inductance is 33.9 and capacitance is 9.722. So all these parameters are approximately same to the value which we have mentioned in our manual. So these are the parameters you can measure with the help of LCR meter. For the measurement of conductance you have to required a meter, ohm meter with a range greater than 100 mega ohm. You can measure the conductance of 100 meter line with the help of this type 100 mega ohm range type ohm meter. So this is your experiment number first. Now we are going to experiment number second. This is the measuring the attenuation of line. For the experiment number 2, adjust RI and RL. This knob is for RI. Adjust this resistance for 18 ohm with the help of DMM. This is your DMM. With the help of this DMM, you can adjust the resistance 18 ohm. This is 18 ohm and RL. This is RL. You can select the RL value with the help of this knob. So adjust this resistance, RL resistance, to 68 ohm. This is 68 ohm, 67.9. And make the connection according to the diagram which we have given in our manual. And according to the diagram, connect the output terminal to RI, one end of RI, and another end of RI is connected to upper end of first block, upper terminal of first block, and the ground terminal of output is connected to lower terminal of first block, input, second input of first block. Thank you. connect this socket to CRO channel 1. This is CRO and this is your channel 1. TP1 to first input of second block, TP2 second input of second block, and TP3 is connected to first input of third block, TP4 is connected to second input of third block, TP5 is connected to first input of fourth block, and TP6 is connected to second input of fourth block, and TP7 is connected to one end of RL, and another end of RL is connected to TP8. So now your connection is completed. I connect the channel 2 of CRO. This is the channel 2 lead, and which is connected to TP8 ground, TP8 and positive lead to TP7. Now CRO is connected, channel 2 of CRO is connected between TP7 and TP8, and first channel is connected to input socket. Set the sine wave frequency to approximate 100 kHz. Just power on the trainer and adjust the frequency. This is frequency counter. This is frequency counter. Positive lead of this counter. Connect the positive lead of this counter to first terminal, first input of block first, and the negative lead of frequency counter is connected to second input of first block. Now your frequency counter is connected to input terminal. Adjust the frequency. This is 100 kHz. And level of this frequency, set it to 0.4 volt peak to peak. This is 0.4 volt peak to peak. So now your frequency generator is set to 100 kHz and 0.4 volt peak to peak value. Oscilloscope channel first shows applied input and channels second shows the outputs. Measure signal level at input. This is your input and this is your output. This is channel first, this is channel second. Measure signal level at input. This is the level which is available on input terminal, and at 25 meter length for the measurement of signal at 25 meter length, just disconnect the second channel of CRO and connect it to TP1 and TP2. connect the second channel of CRO between TP1 and TP2. So this is the signal which is available at 25 meter length. And for the measurement of signal at 50 meter length, connect the second channel between TP3 and TP4, and this is the level, signal level, which is available at 50 meter length. And for the measurement of 75 meter length, connect the second channel between TP5 and TP6, and your channel second shows the level of signal at 75 meter length. And for the measurement of signal at 100 meters, connect the second channel between TP7 and TP8, and this is the signal level which is available at 100 meter length. And tabulate all the values according to table which is given in our manual. This is the table, and you can put the value which you have taken from 25 meter, 50 meter, 75 meter, 100 meter length. Calculate the attenuation in dB at various length with the help of formula which is given in our manual. Try the same with open-ended line and short-ended line. Disconnect the RL. This is your open-ended line. Short the TP7 and TP8. This is your short-end line. So you can measure the attenuation with the help of this trainer. Experiment third is measuring the input impedance of the line. For this experiment, adjust the RI value to 18 ohm and RL value to 68 ohm with the help of digital multimeter. This is the digital multimeter, and we have already selected RI value to 18 ohm and RL value to 68 ohm. So this is the setting. These are the setting of RI and RL, input resistance RI and load resistance RL. Make the connection as the diagram which is shown in our manual. This is the diagram 3. According to this diagram, we are going to connect the different terminals of the trainer. Output, first terminal of output is connected to one end of RI. Another end of this input resistance is connected to first input of block first. This is ground terminal of output, and which is connected to input ground. And this ground is again connected to one end of 1 ohm resistance. This is TP10, and TP9 is the another end of 1 ohm resistance which is connected to second input terminal of first block. And a BNC cable, this is channel 1, this is channel 1 of CRO, and this BNC is connected to input socket. Now channel 1 of CRO is connected to input terminal, and TP1 first input of second block, TP2 is connected to second input of second block, TP3 is connected to first input of third block, TP4 is connected to second input of third block, TP5 is connected to first input of fourth block, and TP6 is connected to second input of fourth block, and TP7 is connected to one end of load resistance. This is RL, which we have selected at 68 ohm, and TP8 is connected to another end of RL resistance, load resistance. Now your connection, second channel of CRO is connected between 1 ohm resistance between TP9 and TP10. Ground lead of CRO is connected to TP10, and positive lead, red lead of CRO is connected to TP9. This connection across the 1 ohm resistance allows to measure the value of input current. We can measure the input current with the help of second channel of CRO, which is connected across the terminal TP9 and TP10. Set the input at 0.4 volt peak to peak, switch on the trainer, and this is the input waveform. Set it to 0.4 volt peak to peak and frequency 100 kilohertz with the help of frequency meter. So we have set it to 0.4 volt peak to peak amplitude and 100 kilohertz of frequency. Take the reading of Vin and Vm. Vin is the input voltage and Vm is the voltage which is appears across the TP9 and TP10 and available on the second channel of CRO. So this is the value of your Vin, input voltage, and this is the value of Vm, which is appears between terminal TP9 and TP10 and across the 1 ohm resistance or across the 1 ohm resistance. Calculate the input impedance according to the formula. Change the frequency to 1 MHz and note the value of Vin and Vm at this frequency. You can change the frequency with the help of this frequency adjustment knob. You can change the frequency of input voltage. You can select the high frequency range with the help of this switch. And take the different readings, and you can set the frequency of input voltage to 1 MHz and measure the value of Vm with the help of CRO. And you can calculate the input impedance according to the formula which is given in our manual. So this is, repeat the experiment with sorted and open line. So this is your experiment number 3rd, which you have done on this, which we have done on this trainer. Experiment 4 is phase displacement between the current and voltage at input of line. For this experiment, adjust RI 18 ohm, This is 18 ohm. Adjust RL 68 ohm. Make the connection. Positive output, one end of RI, another end of RI, connected to first input of first block. Ground terminal of output is connected to lower end of input terminal. TP10 is connected to lower terminal of input socket. TP9 is connected to second input of first block. TP1 connected to first input of block second. TP2 is connected to second input of block second. TP3 is connected to first input of block third. TP4 is connected to TP5, and this is the connection for TP6. TP7 is connected to RL, one end of RL, and TP8 is connected to second end of RL. Now your connection, this is channel 1, CRO channel 1, and this is connected to input terminal and channel 2. Channel 2 is connected between terminal TP9 and TP10. One ohm resistance in series between the generator and the transmission line allows measuring the value of input current. This is your one ohm resistance, which is connected between TP9 and TP10. Set sine wave frequency to 100 kHz. This is your frequency counter. This is your frequency counter. And we are going to set the input waveform. Switch on the unit. This is 100 kHz. Amplitude set the oscilloscope to XY mode. This is your XY mode. Observe suitable lissages pattern. This is your lissages pattern. Observe suitable lissajous pattern on CRO by adjusting volt per division of each channel. Set the proper pattern with the help of volts per division setting on your CRO. You can adjust the amplitude of input voltage for the better pattern. The lissajous pattern allows measuring the phase displacement between the two signals through the ratio of the semi-axis of the ellipse. All procedure for the measurement is given in our manual. So with the help of this lissajous pattern and with the help of your CRO, you can measure the Y1 and Y2 or X1 or X2 and X2, and with the help of formula which is given in our manual, you can measure the phase displacement at 1 kHz frequency. Phase displacement is approx 15 degree. Try it some other frequencies. So this is your experiment 4, phase displacement between the current and voltage at input of line. This is the lissajous pattern for experiment 4. Channel second to the channel second of CRO. Channel first of CRO. You can adjust the amplitude for better lissajous pattern. Now it is at maximum position. And this is the lissajous pattern, and with the help of CRO you can measure the Y1 and Y2, X1 and X2, and calculate the phase displacement. So this is your experiment 4. Experiment number 5 is frequency characteristic of the line. For this experiment, the diagram is shown in our manual. This is the diagram for experiment 5, and we are going to do connection according to this diagram. Output one end of RI, adjust RI and RL for 18 ohm and 68 ohm respectively with the help of DMM, and after that make the connection. TP7 is connected to one end of RL, and TP8 is connected to another end of RL. Adjust the sine wave generator. Connect channel 1 of CRO at input. You can connect BNC to BNC. you can connect BNC to 4 mm page code. So we have connected BNC to 4 mm page code. Set the CRO oscilloscope to 0.1 volt per division. This is 0.1 volt per division setting, and this is also at 0.1 volt per division setting. Adjust the sine wave generator, switch on the supply. Adjust the sine wave generator for an output of 0.2 volt peak to peak, means 2 division deflection on channel 1. 2 division deflection, set the amplitude. This is 2 division deflection on channel 1st at frequency 40 kHz. So measure the frequency. This is your input terminal, and connect BNC to frequency counter. This is your counter. This is your frequency counter. Adjust the frequency with the help of frequency variable knob at 40 kHz. This is 40 kHz frequency. At this point, channel 1 is reading 2 division deflection on channel 2nd. Sorry, channel 1st. At this frequency, frequency is 40 kHz, and channel 1 is reading 2 division deflection. Connect channel 2nd between TP7 and TP8. Channel 2nd is connected. TP7 and TP8. At this frequency, channel 2nd is reading 1.6 division deflection. This is 1.6, this is 2, this is channel 1st, this is channel 2nd. This is due to the fixed attenuation of the line. Now vary the frequency of generator gradually, keeping the input amplitude constant. You can vary the frequency with the help of this knob. This is frequency variable control. You can vary the frequency of generator with the help of this knob. Keeping the input amplitude constant, observe channel 1 and maintain 2 division deflection by adjusting amplitude variable control. Now we are increasing the frequency of input voltage. And till the waveform at the end of 100 meter line falls to 1.4 division, this is minus 3 dB. Channel 2nd waveform, note the channel 2nd waveform. This is channel 1st, this is channel 2nd. Adjust the channel 1st waveform to 2 division deflection with the help of amplitude. Now this is 2 division deflection. and channel second waveform. This is the frequency at which channel 1 reads 2 division deflection and channel 2 reads 1.4 division deflection. 1.4 division deflection means line falls to minus 3 dB. Note this frequency on the oscilloscope. This frequency is known as the cutoff frequency. This is 2 division deflection and this is 1.4 division deflection. And this frequency is, frequency meter is reading 3250 kilohertz, means 3.25 megahertz. So this is the cutoff frequency. For the cable used in this strainer, this frequency is approximately 3.5 megahertz. So we have got the cutoff frequency 3.25 megahertz. So this is the experiment, fifth experiment, frequency characteristic of the line. Vary the frequency of generator gradually, keeping the input amplitude constant till the waveform at the end of 100 meter line falls to minus 3 dB. So minus 3 dB means 1.4 division deflection. This is the waveform which we are receiving at the end of 100 meter cable, and this is the input waveform which we are receiving from input terminal. So this is two division deflection on this wave is 1.4 division deflection, means minus 3 dB pulse. So this is the cutoff frequency of line. Experiment number 6 is a study of stationary waves. For this experiment, connections, all the connections are same as they are in experiment 5. So connections are same as experiment number 5. A diagram is also shown in our manual for the connection. For this experiment, set oscilloscope 2.1 volt per division for both channel. We have already selected it 2.1 volt per division setting in experiment number 5. So these knobs already selected at 0.1 volt per division setting. Adjust the sine wave generator for an output of 0.2 volt peak to peak, means 2 division deflection on channel first. This is channel first waveform and 2 division deflection You can see that two division deflection on channel first, and at frequency 100 kilohertz, so we are going to vary the frequency to 100 kilohertz. This is frequency counter, and this is your 100 kilohertz frequency. At this frequency, again check the channel 1. This is channel 1 waveform. Adjust the amplitude of this waveform with the help of amplitude variable knob. Two division deflection on channel 1 at 100 kilohertz frequency. This is channel 2nd, and channel 2nd is connected to end of the line means TPC, between TP7 and TP8. Observe the peak to peak voltage on channel 2nd. Just remove the channel 2nd from end of the line. Observe the peak to peak voltage of channel 2nd at 100 meter. This is 100 meter. Remove this cable from end of the line, means 100 meter. At intermediate socket at 75 meter, 50 meter, 25 meter and 0 meter. At this point, between TP5 and TP6, this is the waveform between TP5 and TP6. At 75 meter waveform, this is the waveform at 75 meter. You can connect the channel 2nd between TP5 and TP6 and measure the value of waveform at 75 meter. For the measurement at 50 meter, connect the CRO, between TP3 and TP4, this is 50 meter. This is 50 meter reading. For 25 meter reading, connect the CRO between TP1 and TP2. This is the reading of 25 meter. Zero meter reading. Reading at 0 meter, connect the channel 2nd to the input of first block. So you can take the different readings and tabulate these readings in the table which we have given in our manual. At zero distance, channel 2nd reading, volt peak to peak. At 25 meter distance, take reading, and 50 meter, 75 meter and 100 meter. You can take the different readings and calculate the stationary wave ratio by the formula. The reflection coefficient of the line shows how much of the energy supplied at the input is being reflected as the consequence of the load decoupling. Repeat the same procedure for open line and short circuited line. Remove RL. This is your open line and short the RL means short circuited line. Try the experiment with other frequency to see the effect of frequency on stationary wave ratio. So this is your experiment 6. Experiment number 7 is signal phase shift along the line. For this experiment, all the connections are same as they are in experiment 5 or 6. Set oscilloscope to 0.05 volt per division. This is the setting for 0.05 volt per division, 50 millivolt per division setting. So both channels are set to 0.05 volt per division setting. Adjust the sine wave generator for an output of 0.2 volt peak to peak, means 4 division deflection on channel first. Switch on the trainer. This is channel first waveform. Adjust the waveform for 4 division deflection on channel first at frequency 100 kHz. Frequency already selected to 100 kHz. Set the oscilloscope to XY mode. Second channel of CRO is connected between TP7 and TP8. You can change the input. Input terminal, you can connect the input terminal to channel second and end line connection you can feed to channel first of CRO. End line means TP7 and TP8. The terminals are TP7 and TP8 and connected to channel 1 of CRO. Channel 2nd of CRO is connected at input terminal. CRO time per division knob is selected to XY mode. So now your CRO is in XY mode. Measure phase angle by LH formula. When the value of phase displacement has been determined through the measurement, the phase speed can be calculated on the basis of the formula which we have given in our manual. This is the formula. You can calculate the phase speed with the help of this formula. The phase delay is calculated from the ratio of the line length and phase speed. So this is the experiment 7, single phase shift along the line. You can connect N line terminals to channel 2nd. And you can connect the input terminal to channel first. Measure the phase angle by ellipse formula. This is the ellipse. Set the CRO to XY mode and measure the phase angle. After the measurement of phase angle,
You can measure the phase speed, and phase after the phase speed measurement, phase delay is calculated from the ratio of line length and phase speed. So this is the experiment of 7, single phase shift along the line. Experiment 8 is fault localization within the line. For this experiment, make the connection as shown in diagram 7. This is diagram 7. PNC cable to CRO channel 1. TP7 and TP8 is connected to CRO channel 2. Output, first time output is connected to this terminal, and second time is connected to TP7. First reading for this connection, second reading for this connection, and ground is connected to TP8. So now we are going to do connection as a diagram. For the first reading, we have to connect this terminal to this terminal and ground to TP8. This is channel first. Positive lead of channel first is connected to first input of block 1, and negative lead of channel first is connected to second terminal of block 1. TP1, this is TP2 connection, this is TP4 connection, this is TP6 connection, this is TP5. Between TP7 and TP8, connect the second channel of CRO. This is second channel of CRO, adjust the sine generator for output of 0.4 volt peak to peak, set oscilloscope channel first to 0.1 volt per division. This is 0.1 volt per division setting. Adjust the sine wave. Adjust the sine wave, 4 division deflection. So this is 4 division deflection of channel 1. Keep the frequency variable control at the minimum position. This is now, this is frequency control knob, and we have put it to minimum position. Gradually increase the frequency. First, note that the line is broken at 50 meter length, 25, 25, so this is 50 meter length, this is another 50 meter length, and line is broken, suppose line is broken at 50 meter length, so we have not connected TP3 to next terminal. So this is disconnected. Suppose the line is broken, Gradually increase the frequency and note the frequency at which the signal on CRO falls to minimum. This frequency is F1. Now we are going to increase the frequency. Full. Put the switch to high position and again start the frequency increasing from minimum position. Gradually increase the frequency and note the frequency at which the signal on CRO falls to minimum. This is minimum value. Again, we are increasing the frequency, and this is the minimum value of amplitude of input signal. This frequency is F1. Note down this frequency. With the help of frequency meter, the frequency is 890 kHz. So this is your F1. Repeat the test at the output side. Remove the output positive terminal and connect it to TP7. And now this is your channel 2. This is minimum position and frequency of this we are connecting the frequency counter. This is already connected to channel 2. This is output positive. For the second reading, we have to connect this output positive to TP7. And this is the lead for frequency counter. And frequency counter, now counting the frequency at which the waveform is minimum. So this is the frequency 890 kHz, 892 kHz. So this is your F2. Enter these value in the formula and calculate the distance of breakpoint from the input. This is the formula. Put the value of F1 and F2 in this formula and calculate the distance of breakpoint from the input. For the force generated at 50 meter, F1 and F2 are 900 900 kilohertz approximate. So we have got the frequency F1 and F2 900 kilohertz approximately. So this is your experiment 8. Experiment number 9 is line under pulsed condition. This is the diagram 8. Make connections as shown in diagram 8. So we are going to connect according to this diagram, adjust RI and RL for 18 ohm and 68 ohm. So which we have already set these RI and RL for 18 ohm and 68 ohm respectively. So we are going to make connection according to the diagram 8. Positive terminal of output is connected to one end of RI. Another end of RI is connected to first terminal, upper terminal of block 1. Ground terminal of output is connected to lower terminal of input circuit. And lower terminal of block 1 is connected to lower terminal of input circuit TP1 to next terminal, TP3 to next, TP5 to next terminal, TP2 to next, and TP4 the next terminal, and TP6 is connected to also to next terminal. TP7 is connected one end of RL, and TP8 is connected another end of RL. CRO channel 1 is connected, this is channel 1, and channel 1 is connected first terminal of block 1, and ground of CRO is connected to lower end of input circuit. Now your channel 1 is connected to input terminal, and this is CRO channel 2nd. CRO channel 2nd is connected between TP7 and TP8. So this is your channel 2nd. Observe the input and output wave shape and also amplitude level on the oscilloscope. Switch on the unit and put the toggle switch to low position. This is sign position, this is amplitude, this is frequency. This is your input signal, this is your signal between TP7 and TP8, end of the line. Now make the load open and repeat the same procedure. Now your load is open. And this is your output at the end of line, and this is the input which we have connected to input terminal from generator. Now again repeat the experiment for short circuited load. When you connect TP7 and TP8, this is a short circuit load. Note the observation for all three conditions. First is 68 ohm selected load, second is load open, and third is short circuit load. So note the observation for all three conditions of load and compare them. So this is your experiment number 9, line under pulsed condition. You can take the reading of open condition of load, short circuit condition of the load, and the 68 ohm load. So this is your experiment number 9. Thank you.